Hello and welcome to the 7 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Lebrick. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa ratified and issued two laws for the year 2017 after they were approved by the representatives and Shura councils. Law 4 of 2017 ratifies the Arab Convention to Combat Transnational Organized Crime, which was signed in Cairo on the 21st of December 2010. Law 5 ratifies the agreement between the governments of Bahrain and India regarding cooperation to combat terrorism, transnational organized crime, and the illegal drug trade. The agreement was signed in New Delhi on the 2nd of December 2015. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa attended the wedding ceremony of Sheikh Khalifa bin Ali Al Khalifa, the grandson of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, which took place yesterday evening at His Royal Highness's palace in Rafah. The ceremony was also attended by senior royal family members and VIP guests. His Majesty the King offered congratulations to His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Deputy Prime Minister His Highness Sheikh Ali bin Khalifa Al Khalifa and His Highness Sheikh Khalifa bin Ali bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, wishing them a life filled with joy and happiness. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister expressed deep appreciation of His Majesty the King's noble feelings, praying to the Almighty to bless him with abundant good health and happiness.
Thank you.
His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa today issued Edict 4 of 2017, appointing two directors at the Ministry of Interior. Lieutenant Colonel Muhammad Ali Khalil Al Bin Khalil, appointed as Director of the Ministry of Interior, and Major Fatma Umar Abdulrahman Al Abdelghaffar as Director of the Health and Social Affairs Directorate. The Minister of Interior is responsible for transferring and appointing the directors monitored to any vacant directorate at the ministry if necessary. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman received today at Khudaybiyah Palace the deputy premiers and a number of senior officials. His Royal Highness affirmed that attempts to disrupt security will not deter the government's determination to root out terrorism. The Prime Minister stressed that it is the government's duty to secure stability and establish security. He also added that anyone who is directly or indirectly linked to any attempt to target stability will be under the penalty of law and justice. During the meeting, His Royal Highness stressed the importance of besieging terrorists and preventing them from executing plans that target societal security. He noted that social media has become a large source of information that must be used as a media platform that serves national unity, development and progress, and not a means of spreading messages targeting the social fabric and promoting extremist ideologies. He also added that this matter must be followed by the concerned authorities. His Royal Highness also asserted that any matter regarding the security of the nation is of utmost importance. The Prime Minister also affirmed that the kingdom extends its hand in cooperation to various countries that share its keenness to establish relations based on mutual respect, and looks from some countries that provide a cover for terrorism in Bahrain to review their positions and policies. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received yesterday evening at Rifa Palace, in the presence of the Deputy Prime Minister Sheikh Ali bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, a number of the senior royal family members who congratulated him on the marriage of Sheikh Khalifa bin Ali bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, wishing Sheikh Khalifa a happy wedded life. His Royal Highness also received the Gulf congratulations delegations, among which was the delegation from Qatar, headed by the personal representatives of the Emir of Qatar, His Highness Sheikh Tamim bin Hamad Al Thani, Sheikh Jassim bin Hamad Al Thani, the delegation of Kuwait headed by Sheikh Mish'al Al Ahmed Al Sabah, Sheikh Nasser Al Sabah Al Ahmed Al Sabah, Sheikh Ibrahim Al Dahej Al Sabah, Sheikh Abdullah Muhammad Al Abdullah Al Sabah, Sheikh Sabah Al Abdullah Mubarak Al Sabah, and Sheikh Fahad Muhammad Al Abdullah Mubarak Al Sabah. The delegation of the United Arab Emirates, headed by Sheikh Mohammed bin Hamdan bin Zayed Al Nahyan, Sheikh Mohammed bin Hayyan bin Mubarak Al Nahyan, Sheikh Shakbut bin Hayyan bin Mubarak Al Nahyan, and Sheikh Abdullah bin Muhammad Al Thani. His Royal Highness also received a number of dignitaries and businessmen from the Gulf Cooperation Council, the GCC, headed by Darwish Al Darwish and his sons, the family of Al Mani', headed by Abdullah bin Khalid Al Mani', and the dignitaries Adil Ali bin Ali Al Salmani. They all wished Sheikh Khalifa a happy married life. His Royal Highness expressed thanks and appreciation to the delegations for their kind sentiments, which reflect the deep-rooted relations between their countries and Bahrain.
Yeah. والهيج كنه للرعد زلزال.
Thank you.
the representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Work and Youth Affairs, Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, and President of Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, affirmed that Bahrain has managed to become a pioneer in empowering the youth under the wise leadership and directives of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa. He noted that the launch of His Majesty King Hamad's Award for Increasing Youth Participation in Achieving the Goals of Sustainable Development stems from His Majesty's belief that the kingdom is responsible for preparing and enabling the youth to take part in the development march. His Highness said that the award came to urge public and private institutions to empower the youth, adding that the youth has become a main source for innovation and development in the world. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa deputized the Minister of Youth and Sports Affairs, Hisham bin Mohammed Al Joder, to deliver His Majesty's letter to the UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres, where His Envoy on Youth Ahmed Al Hindawi received it. In the letter, His Majesty expressed interest in enhancing cooperation between the Kingdom and the UN in various fields and in providing the suitable environment for them to participate in achieving the goals of sustainable development. Al Joder launched King Hamad Award for Increasing Youth Participation in Achieving the Goals of Sustainable Development in the UN headquarters in New York during the opening session of the 6th Economic and Social Council Youth Forum entitled The Role of Youth in Poverty Eradication and Promoting Prosperity in a Changing World. Al Joder affirmed that the King's Award is his initiative to encourage the government, private, civil sectors and individuals to involve the youth in order to improve the infrastructure related to them. He added that the Kingdom has applied policies that stem from their interest in global youth, where His Majesty the King, the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, and the Crown Prince Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa have reflected in the government program of prioritizing youth, hailing the representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Work and Youth Affairs, Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sport, and President of Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa's support and follow-up of the awards launch stages. The Youth Affairs Minister commended the efforts of the Foreign Minister under the leadership of the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed bin Mohammed Al Khalifa, in cooperating with the Ministry of Youth and Sports Affairs to prepare for the award. He stated that this cooperation resulted in the success of the event and in achieving its goals, praising the efforts of the permanent mission of the Kingdom to the UN. The Speaker of the Representatives Council, Ahmed Al-Mulla, chaired today the weekly meeting where the Council approved issuing a statement regarding supporting legal procedures and demanding tighter penalties and retribution in order to maintain security. They also approved to issue another statement on celebrating Arab Women Day, which is held every year on the 1st of February. The Council also approved three reports regarding air transport agreement between Bahrain and Czech, air services agreement with Hungary, and another air services agreement with Georgia. The Council then approved two reports on amending judiciary law and amending procedural law in courts. The meeting approved a proposal regarding the establishment of a traditional market and another proposal on workers' contracts and bachelor's residence. The meeting then approved a number of proposals regarding allowing Bahraini sellers to sell in parks and public beaches, holidays and special occasions and events according to the set conditions, recruit unemployed Bahraini nurses, stop gold stamping fees recently imposed by the Ministry of Industry, Commerce and Tourism Affairs. Bahrain condemned the terrorist attack that targeted a Saudi frigate monitoring the western part of Hodeidah port in Yemen, killing and injuring a number of the ship crew members. Bahrain offers condolences to the families of the martyrs and wishes the injured a speedy recovery, stating that such terrorist acts reflect the instances of Houthi militias to obstruct all efforts aiming to reach a political solution and threatening the freedom of international navigation, as well as preventing humanitarian aid for Yemeni people. Bahrain affirms its full support to the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia and its efforts in maintaining the region's security and combating terrorism. It also confirms its commitment to participate in the Arab coalition to support the legitimacy of Yemen and to reach a peaceful solution. According to the Gulf Initiative, the outcomes of the National Dialogue and the UN Security Council Resolution 2216. A press conference headed by Attorney General Dr. Ali bin Fadl al-Bu'aynain discussed the public prosecution's announcement, which stated that the number of cases in 2016 and 2017 has reached 117,950 cases, from which 116,586 were settled, while the number of offenses that have been disposed of completely by the prosecution was 2,771 offenses. The conference also reviewed the details of the public prosecution's annual report of the year 2016, where it stated the positive statistics of the rapid decline of offense indicators in the kingdom, noting that the public prosecution was keen on being present in many conferences and seminars that contribute to the development of its employees and which aim to refine their abilities and to form a better understanding of human rights in criminal matters. Also, efforts were exerted to develop the skills of public prosecution members. A Kuwaiti public prosecution delegation paid a visit to Bahrain's public prosecution. Also, public prosecution member Attorney General Ahmed Al-Hammadi was honored with an excellence award. And according to Decision 1 of 2016, child prosecution was changed to become family and child prosecution. Public prosecution joined a number of events in 2016 and contributed to the field of training and education through the visits of university students. It also celebrated Bahraini Women's Day in the judicial and legal field under the patronage of Her Royal Highness, the wife of His Majesty the King, Princess Sabika bint Ibrahim Al Khalifa.
We believe in the international cooperation. We are part of this world. We sign a lot of memorandum of understanding with five countries until now. We hope that we can do it more and more within the next years. And we believe in because the criminal activities is very fast now. We should be rapidly like them. Otherwise, we will fail to face them. So I think now we have more cooperation within the international arena. And I hope to continue this work, inshallah. All the crimes, I mean, from, as we mentioned, from towards 50, if you come to 100%, towards 51%, now it's been 49%. All these, because a lot of affects, I mean, within the police or the public prosecution, or even the judges there. And we also we believe in on the community and how they help us to reduce the number of the crimes. I hope that we can continue in this excellent work, and I hope that next year also, inshallah, will be more or less, inshallah.